Welcome and thank you for joining Andre Rene's Creative Cafe. This is a show that focuses on the arts and the artists' God-given talent. We strongly believe that you are your passion. And if this is your first time joining us, welcome, enjoy, and you will be uplifted. Today we have a friend to the show. He's no stranger, he's been here before. But before we start with our friend, I just have a few words to say. Late last night or early this morning, I got some disturbing news. My friend Moses Robinson passed away. About 6 months ago, I noticed on his Facebook page that he was talking about going back and forth to the hospital. So I thought, you know, he was talking about his mom, because, you know, I lost my mom in 2011. And so, you know, it's that season, kind of, sort of. And so, come to find out it was him. And so I saw, maybe a week or two ago, him skydiving. And I was like, is this his bucket list? But I was joking, like, a bucket list, right? And maybe it was, because he passed away. Moses Robinson was a big influence in my life right after I was discharged from the Navy. I was in Army ROTC. And there was three concerts that I had in my life in high school. Band, ROTC, and I never got in trouble, because that just wasn't me. And my sophomore year, I was the command sergeant major. That was the highest ranking sophomore, second year ROTC person you could be. And I had dreams of having a military life. And so when I came home and I was discharged from the Navy, I was like, dude, you know, I wasn't lost. I just wanted the military. And he was one of the voices. And there's other people. You just have that bond. But Moses was a great person. So this show is not a tribute to him. This show really is about you, no doubt, my guest, Mr. Quentin Sanders.
Yeah, of course.
But I wanted to make mention that it's sad that when I started this journey with my books and this radio show, and when I went to a different chapter but in the same location, I noticed that all our communication has been Facebooking. And I was thinking, like, this was, it's so impersonal, because it felt like he was miles away. He was a 15-minute drive. So we want to say rest in peace, Moses Robinson. We love you. To this family, I know you're going through, wow, words escape me, and I'm shocked. I'm just literally shocked. I'm in a daze, because he was such a good, mild-mannered person. So rest in peace, Moses Robinson. But guys, the reason why it touched me, we was Facebooking instead of talking, and we was talking about getting together, but we was satisfied with what you're doing and what you're not doing, and so on and so forth. And I think the impersonal, that social media has made us such impersonable people, that we'd rather, you know, do an inbox, DM, or whatever they call it, and, right, and then, you know, tag somebody. The face-to-face, the coffee, let's sit down, let's talk. So I pray, and I use the words pray sincerely, I pray that God give us the guidance that we could go knock on the door and, you know, have a chat face-to-face. Yes. Let's get this human interaction going.
Definitely.
So, again, you are in our prayers, and just, you know, be strong. God could bring you guys through, family, friends, however. Moses Robinson, rest in peace. You are missed.
Rest in peace.
Rest in peace. So, hey, guys, back to my buddy, Quentin Sanders. You are so much a stuntman. You are an actor. You are a film. You know, I mean, you're like a powerhouse. We were in the park.
Mm-hmm.
And the young lady was like, I remember you, right? And he was like, oh, I'm not doing anything. I was like, dude, you know who this is. And he had a new fan. She was like, take pictures with me, Instagram me. I was like, see, how it's going to go.
Good times.
They good times. So, hey, what's going on?
Yeah, you know, nothing much. Just, you know, the usual, working hard, playing harder.
Right.
Living and loving.
There you go, living and loving. As you put it, keeping it golden.
Keeping it golden, stay golden.
Where did that come from?
Yeah, actually, I was reading The Outsiders back in, what, fourth or fifth grade, and I really loved that. You know, Pony Boy dyed his hair blonde, and he told him to stay golden. And that just means to stay gold, to live, stay pure, don't get tainted by, you know, the fight versus the greasers and the cells, but just be your own man, be cool, be pure, and I really like that, so that stayed with me.
Yeah, keep it going. Right. Am I saying about keeping it going?
Yeah, keep it golden, stay golden, stay golden, golden, all of it, cool. All of the above.
Now, the last time you were here, you had a movie premiere that was coming up.
Yeah, it's a chance in the world.
Now, talk to now. It's out there. Tell us what's going on.
Yeah, so, you know, I've got a WeatherTech commercial now.
Mm-hmm.
So, of course, you know, I do act. I do transform into a new person with the certain projects. But for this commercial on WeatherTech, I was using a different skill that I have, and that was my parkour, free running, and martial arts. Mm-hmm. And I really enjoyed doing this project mainly because I wasn't shifting into someone else.
Right.
You know, I was me. You know, chance in the world, right. I was like the bad guy.
Right.
But, you know, in real life,
right.
far from it.
Right. Indeed.
You know, I got to do side flips, front flips
right.
for the commercial, and
right.
we did two commercials.
Right. Although one of the ones, there's a family near a park,
mm-hmm.
and you come by the tree. Is that one of your commercials?
Yeah, that's me.
Yeah, so walk us through that commercial. We can, right?
Yeah. Oh, okay. Totally walk it through behind the scenes and everything.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so believe it or not, mm-hmm. it was a 14-hour shoot.
Oh, I believe it.
And for 8 of those hours, it was raining. So I really don't know how they edited, like, the rain out.
Right.
But they did. And it was cool. I was slipping and sliding. Right. Trust me, people. But, yeah, so I didn't have to audition for this role. And that, with me going in, I felt really confident because I knew they wanted me for this. And I
mm-hmm.
was like, oh, yeah, I'm just going to do my thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to dive through, like, a tire.
Right.
And I didn't fit. So I just had to dive on, like, the side of it. So
right.
it's a real, like, cool editing thing that made
right.
it look like I'm diving through the hole
right.
when I'm going through it. And
the magic is of production.
Yes, the right. magic of production.
Of post-production.
Post-production.
Right, indeed.
Got to give the editors credit, come on.
Now, what type of tire did they have you diving to that you couldn't fit?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was like a, you know, like a, those tires that you swing on.
Uh-huh.
You guys know.
Like it was a small
tire.
Huge, so small. Was it a car tire? Couldn't have been a car
tire.
Oh, I didn't think so.
No.
Right.
And then, like, I had the helmet on, the
right.
motorcycle gear, so I couldn't fit through that.
Right.
I did try.
Yeah. When I saw the commercials, I was like, I bet you that's Quentin right there.
Mm.
Yeah, I was, you know, looking at the gate and looking at the size, like, that's probably Quentin right there. And I look like
my man.
Yeah. So we was happy to see a young, tell the audience how old you are.
Yeah, I'm 20 years old, guys.
Right. He's my daughter's age. And and just FYI, don't go near.
Oh. I'm scared, guys. Oh, man. That was on air.
I know. Right? It was. I know. Right? You know, when you get your degree, you're good.
Yeah.
After that, then we're good to go. Then we're working to the phone.
All right, okay. Yeah. Okay, cool.
High standards, right?
I don't know if it was good. Yeah,
if she's listening, she's like, what this dude?
She's like, oh, Dad.
Dad, really?
Oh, man.
Right, you know.
It's what parents do, you know.
She's grown. Okay, insist on anything, but God bless her.
Definitely.
When you were, I noticed after you left the show, you had other appearances, right?
Yeah.
So when we come back from these commercials breaks, they're sponsored by St. Augustine Episcopal Church of Gary. We're going to talk about the movie that you were in.
Ooh.
Right back, guys.
And we are back with Quentin Sanders.
Hey.
Actor, stuntman, martial arts enthusiast.
Oh, man.
He reminded me during the break that he's a black belt and all the other things that scared me to death. So I'm not going to bother him right now. When we met, he was like, hey, man, you know, I got you. If you need some help, you let me know. I was like, this guy must be really good at what he does.
Oh, you know.
Yeah, thank God for gunpowder. But God bless you. So we are Father God in the name of Jesus to all our competitors or whatever things that may go on. And we have a peaceful.
Yeah.
Then we'll just keep it. We'll keep it going.
Yeah, keep it going.
Right. So nobody gods today.
Oh, man, he's right, guys.
Right. And so let's go back to A Chance in the World.
Yeah, totally.
Now, did you write the whole thing?
No, Chance in the World was, I just acted in that one.
Okay, acted. Yeah. Okay. I'm just an actor, that's all.
No, it was directed by and written by Mark Vadik, and
mm-hmm.
it's based on Steve Pemberton's life,
mm-hmm.
and he's the author of the book.
A Chance in the World. A Chance in the World, that's the name of the book and
yes,
the movie.
And the movie.
Copy
yep,
that.
Yep, yep. Okay. And it was out May 30th in theaters.
Right.
And I was Reggie, the bad guy. I was the abusive foster brother.
Hmm.
So, you know.
I'm seeing a theme here. Mm-hmm. WeatherTech commercial, you the bad guy. Chance in the World, you the bad guy. You sure you're not a bad guy?
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
No.
Now, we sent somebody to the premiere. I was unable. I had a prior engagement that I wasn't aware of.
Yeah, no
and I heard you were doing stunts at the... Yes.
So, the movie theater had a little bit of technical difficulties, the one I was in. So, the movie didn't play at first.
Okay.
So, of course, you know, it's my first movie and it's the premiere and I got to keep the people entertained.
Right.
So, I walked out there and I started doing backflips and side flips.
Oh, wow.
You know, and everyone was like, what, in a suit?
I know, right? Oh, wow.
So, yeah, no, it was pretty cool. It was groovy.
Yeah. How long did it take you guys to film the movie?
Yeah, it took us, I want to say,
4 to 5 weeks. That's how long I was on, at least.
Right, right. That was your part.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
If I remember correctly. Right. Definitely.
What I did, my first and only extra gig, we was only there 22 hours.
Ooh.
Yeah.
That's kind of long.
And I had a non-speaking role.
Huh.
Yeah.
That's still pretty long.
It's Will Smith. Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah. It was amazing. I didn't even know that was Michael Mann.
Mm.
I wasn't familiar with him at the time.
Wow.
And he
wild.
Was 10 feet away from me.
Michael
Mann.
Do you guys hear me? Wow.
So we was coming in, and it's like, Big Willie, that's when he was called Big Willie.
Uh-huh.
They said, Big Willie is coming. I said, where's Jada? She was right in front of me.
Ooh.
I was like, I should be embarrassed.
Oh,
but
man.
That's Jada. That's Tupac's. Well, I guess it's Will
Smith.
Right, right.
Will
Smith's wife. Right, right. So it was that. So even though at the time I was a fan of his creativity,
mm-hmm.
and you know, Jada's Jada. But I didn't know who Michael Mann was. But if I would have knew who he would turn out to be, not film wise,
mm-hmm.
but how he promotes, how he educates, mm-hmm. how he uplifts.
Totally.
Will Smith is the man.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And he tells you, I'm not the best actor, I'm mm-hmm. the hardest working actor. And my brother taught me that as a kid. See, I'm not the smartest kid in the room. I'm the one who stays up all night to learn everything.
Mm.
That's how I made straight A's in college.
I love that.
Right. So it's like I work really hard.
Mm-hmm.
So, and that's an inaccurate statement. I did get a C in Spanish. You know, goose to Espanol. You know,
je parle français.
Oh, obviously, yeah. There you go.
I
there
suck
go.
At Spanish people.
Right. Yeah, right. So, what was the biggest role you went out for?
Yeah, I would say Reggie is the biggest role that I went out for because
okay.
and a chance to roll because, you know, it was in theaters and the other stuff that I've the other projects that I've worked on has majority been on TV. So, mm-hmm. yeah. Like a commercial.
Okay.
So,
okay.
yeah.
Right.
So, definitely Reggie and a chance to roll was my biggest role because,
right.
you know, the nation saw it.
Right.
They
indeed.
Saw me.
Indeed.
Yeah.
And the thing about the show, people, mm-hmm. just in case you're unfamiliar with the show, if you're new, in the beginning, we tell you we're a show that focuses on the arts and the artist's God-given talent. Here's an actor and a stuntman, and this is what we promote. We want you and Radio Land, who's listening, or when you see the video, to listen to what he's telling you. He's telling you what he's doing. Because this week, you went on 7 different auditions?
7 auditions, yes.
Wow.
Yep, you have 4 Monday, 2 Tuesday, and 1 Wednesday.
Wow.
And I met with you.
Right, right. And we had that very, very hot photo shoot.
Oh man, it was hot, guys.
And the heel we had to climb. I don't even think they realized that.
Nope.
They're gonna see the pictures and they'll know that we was up on top of a hill.
We were high, guys.
Yes, and kids was running around us 4 or 5 times.
Oh my gosh. It was a sight, guys. I mean, they didn't stop. They didn't run out of gas. No, like.
Yeah, I'm tired thinking about it.
Oh man.
Yeah. So wow, 7 auditions. So you have to put in the work.
Put in the work. You know, my odds are good.
Right. I've
got to book one of them.
Indeed. How good are they called talent agents?
Yeah.
How good are they?
Oh, they're great.
Are they your friend or
yes. Both. It's very personal and very business like with Ambassador Talent.
Mm-hmm. Shout out to Ambassador.
Yeah. Shout out to Ambassador Talent. Mm-hmm. Susan Sherman and Ed Cox. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much for building up my career and, you know, making me who I am.
And putting Andre Rene on. did y'all get the Susan? Hello, Susan. Did you pick up the phone, Susan?
Uh-oh.
We're calling.
We'll call
her. We're texting, right.
We'll let her know.
I knocked on the door. I was around it all the day.
He is a riot, guys. I'm telling you. Oh, man. You should see the energy right now.
I know, right? Who were your major influences?
Yeah, I want to say Michael B. Jordan. Definitely a big influence in my...
I remember that, right.
Yeah.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And actually, up and coming now, Will Smith. Mm-hmm. I'm really starting to watch like his choices that he makes on screen, and I'm really enjoying him as an actor.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to say that he is a new influence in my life and my acting style. So
he's as I stated earlier, when you go to my YouTube channel, and I hope you guys can see this, but it doesn't matter if you can. But I downloaded a lot of the inspirational quotes.
Mm-hmm.
As an entrepreneur of all my life,
mm-hmm.
Basically outside of the Navy. When me and Moses Robinson was talking about me going forward, you know, we talk about regular jobs, but, you know, we also know you have to follow your passion.
Yeah.
I always wanted to be a businessman. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, I did just that. And from 20 years to now, I've been in business. And so when you talk to people like me or people that has high, intense jobs, let's say that, you have to find some way to motivate yourself.
Definitely.
And right now, excuse me, guys, Will Smith has a lot of videos that's doing just that.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm a big fan now because of that. I like his acting. Yeah. Any movie he put out, I'm a fan. Even the ones they said tank, he never tanked with me. No. But when he gets on the microphone or you make that video telling you you can do it, mm-hmm. in short, he gives you the meat and potatoes. Yeah. I like on that commercial, that video, the movie with him and his son, mm-hmm. and he had that son feels not real. It's a product of your imagination.
Uh-huh.
I love that.
Yeah.
I love that.
Totally.
I love how you could take the thoughts of failure and put it in your tank. Mm. And give you energy to go forward. You make that your kinetic energy.
Definitely.
I love that. So I'm a big fan of Will Smith.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm going to take another commercial break, guys. And these commercial breaks are sponsored by Finish Line Auto, located in Hammond, Indiana. And we're back with Quentin Sanders and Andre Renee.
Howdy.
And thank you for tuning in. And Mr. Sanders is going to tell us, what advice would you give someone like myself wants to get in your business?
Yeah, totally. My advice to you is, first and foremost, please put God first. Because when you put God first, he just throws you right to the top. It'll be unbelievable. You wouldn't even know it. You'll like wake up the next morning and you just have like 100 auditions. And you're going to book one at least.
Mm-hmm.
Next thing I would say is get a really good headshot. You know, headshots are the first thing that casting directors see from you. And it can make or break you. You know, they have a certain look for specific roles. And if you have that look, your headshot will let them know. And then get yourself a good agent. I recommend Ambassador Talent. Right. Because they're really good.
Because I'm waiting on that call from them to me.
For you.
Right. It's been 2 days, guys. I'm just saying.
Oh, they're open on the weekends. You know that?
I know it now. Thank you for correcting me, sir.
No worries.
Let's see. Ambassador Talent.
Ambassador Talent.
That's wonderful. So... The more, I want to touch on what you said.
Okay.
That if you go out for 100, you'll get one.
Yeah, you got
it. So it's a numbers game.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So when you go out and you do 100 interviews or auditions and you get zero, or you had 90.
It's happened.
Okay, so you did 90 interviews and you had zero.
Yep.
Where's your morale?
Honestly, stressfully, I just go and do parkour. Just like, I'll get the next one.
Right.
Or the next one.
And parkour is what again?
Parkour is the art of getting from point A to point B in the fastest time possible. And free running is adding flips to it.
Okay. So that's your stress relief.
That is my stress relief.
My Harley Davidson is my stress relief.
Everyone's got one.
Indeed.
Yeah.
So when you're out there and you're trying and you seem like you're failing, you're not failing.
Yeah, not at all.
Right.
Here, trust me, you're going to go on a lot of auditions and you're not going to get them, unfortunately, but there is one out there for you. And with one, there are two, and with two, there are four.
Indeed.
So just keep going, guys.
Really. I had a book sale, I was going to say a book deal, and so this library, they have a few branches.
Ooh.
I went there 5 separate times, and I was thinking, the 5th time, I was not feeling this. But the persistence in me, it drives me unconsciously. And so as I was going to this library, I said, what am I doing here? And not only did they purchase all of my books, a big bundle of books, but they allowed me to speak. And then you go to another place, and the first few words is, well, how do we buy your books?
Wow.
And now you send them invoices, and you have this large order. And so on one hand, you have to go 5 times. On another hand, you have to say 2 words.
Boom.
And so I believe a person should focus on this.
Okay.
You have to focus on the days of plenty when you have days of famine.
Definitely.
So remember the Anno Sloven Man. That's the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
And so he stores and stores and stores. And so when he came for the winter for our area, they're not outside getting it because they already have it.
Boom.
And so that's what we have to do. And sometimes someone will call you. It's like, I haven't forgotten you. And then that cell is there. So be persistent.
Definitely, be persistent.
Persistence paves the way to prosperity, people.
Amen.
Persistence paves the way to prosperity. So never stop the hustle.
Never.
My life coach, I'm calling her that. I don't know what she wants to be called, but she hates that word hustle.
Ooh.
And when it slips out, she's like, I get this long speech. Don't use the word hustle. I haven't learned another word, so there
it's
we go.
It's the come up, you know.
I know, right?
Come on.
What's your blueprint for success?
My blueprint, for success. I wouldn't say that I have one. I would just say that it's second nature to me. It's just I know that I have to do good, and I know that the world is expecting me to leave something in it and something positive. So with that in my mind, I just go out there knowing the best me that I can be and just rock it as best as possible. And that's how I really gauge my success, if you can call that a blueprint.
No. You said, and I love it because I said, you said the world expects me to leave something behind.
It does.
The world. When I rolled over one day, and 6 months later, excuse me, people.
Yeah, no worries.
I had 6 books. I knew right then and there those were my legacy. They said, "Do you have other books?" I do, but my goal right now is my legacy, and so I want to know if it all ends today. Have I left something behind? And having a cleaning service, someone could say you clean my carpets. That wasn't enough, and so that's why our books are dealt with love, compassion. We had a few extremely intelligent people behind closed doors, guiding and making sure that we had a nice product for children. So yes, I love when you said, and to say that at 20.
Yeah.
I love that. But I met your family. Yeah. And people don't know you come from a powerhouse with the doctors and the educators and just everybody that you have there.
Just rocking it.
Yeah, oh, you're killing it. Yeah, you're killing it. I was like, adopt me. That's like, you're older than us. So I was like, you got a point.
Bro, you're my brother already.
There you go. What does failure means to you?
Yeah, failure. I've had a lot of failure. You know, I do parkour, free running, / gymnastics, and martial arts. So, of course, failure is also second nature to me. And it's just a learning curve. You know, when you do something wrong 20 times and you fail the same way 20 times, you're going to do better the next time. And it's going to just make you that much better in life because now you've learned from those failures and you can go out and even teach someone else. Because once you have that experience of the failure, you can stop someone else from failing the same way you did. And help them succeed in a way that you couldn't or a way that you found out later. So that's what failure is to me.
Failure is a teacher.
Yeah, exactly.
Failure teaches you.
A mentor.
Wow. In this segment of What Would Jesus Do? It relates to what we talked about earlier about my friend, may he rest in peace, Moses Robinson.
Yes.
West Side High School graduate, go West Side, but we're mourning right now.
Yes.
So What Would Jesus Do? What would Jesus do outside the social media platform? Would Jesus just leave pokes and likes and hearts and memes and all these things? Or would Jesus actually go out, knock on the door, say, "Hi, it's Jesus. How are you?" And so I want you guys to ponder that within yourself. I usually ask you to go back and put it on my board and I usually have the guests answer it, and I answer it. But I want that to weigh on your mind. What are you doing today? Do you have friends that you love, but you deal with them through social media? And I'm at fault for that. Do you have people that you only know through social media you never met? I mean, what is going on? Is social media making us like these robots that we see each other in public? I was at an event, and a lady said, "I'm your Instagram friend." I didn't even know her. I'd never seen it before.
Wow.
I tried to sell a book, because that's what I do. And so at the end of the day, don't let social media be your everything. Don't let it be your God. Don't let it be what you do as far as the first thing you get up. The guy said, when you get up, don't touch your phone for an hour. If you have to touch your phone within an hour, you're addicted. And if you have to go to Facebook or social media, you're addicted. So we want to ask that God protect us. We want to ask that God heal the land. We want to ask that God give us the guidance so we can be better people. People, this is a Christian show. So we believe in Jesus, and we ask you right now for your passion, your strength, your guidance. Be with us, Lord, so we can be better people, so we can be better towards you, so we can show an example for the people that's coming up, that we can engage our people face to face. God bless you. We love you. Yes. Thanks for listening. And remember, you need to be a statement of truth and a true statement. Ponder that. And know this, you are your passion. God bless you. Talk to you next time. Thank you, Mr. Sanders.
Thank you.
All right. Words of encouragement. The loss of a loved one has to be an impossible time in your life. For this I am sorry. You have my prayers and thoughts of sympathy. Know that God is able and willing to encourage you. Plan for our life sometimes involves a road that is rough to travel, bear pain and sacrifice in fighting a demonic battle. Please know this, as saints of the Most High, we should never have the spirit of fear.